Yeah, good morning all.
Good morning, sir.
We are discussing about the Maxwell equations. One of the important character of the characteristic of the Maxwell equation is transport of energy from one place to another place. This transport of energy from one place to another place can be explained by using the Poynting theorem. Here some vector is there, that is a P. By using this vector, Poynting vector, we can analyze the energy transport from one place to another place by using the electromagnetic waves. So now we will discuss about Poynting theorem. So what is this Poynting theorem? The Poynting theorem or Poynting vector can be defined as P can be defined as the rate of change of energy. If the energy is u, that is rate of change of energy is dou u by dou t, because t is the time. Rate of change of energy per unit this area, that is by ds, is called Poynting vector. So Poynting vector is equal to rate of change of energy or rate of passing of energy per unit area is called Poynting vector. If it is coming this side, that is dou u by dou t is equal to p dot ds. If you want to require total energy, that can be taken as integration, and it is if the energy is entering into the volume, it may be taken as minus. So the Poynting vector can be defined as p is, if it is, that is minus dou u by dou t is equal to integration p dot ds. Now our aim is, what is the value of p? The value of p is depending on the intensity of electric field, that is capital E, and intensity of magnetic field, that is B R H. The Poynting vector p is equal to E cross H. That is our final destination. Of course we know B is equal to B naught H. So that H is equal to B by mu naught. From this, the Poynting vector P is equal to E cross H. B by H is replaced by B by mu naught. That is 1 by mu naught. So the Poynting vector P is equal to E cross H, or P is equal to 1 by mu naught into E cross B. Now we will derive this Poynting vector by using this concept. So now what we require? The total energy is required. To derive this concept, we want to assume a parallel pattern. Whose length is dx, width is dy, and height is dz. Electromagnetic waves which are passing along the positive x-axis. These are electromagnetic waves. Now what happens if these waves are entering into the volume? The area which is perpendicular to the electromagnetic waves is, this is dy into dz. Of course it may be taken as ds, where ds is equal to dy into dz. Area is equal to length into breadth by using that principle. Now what is the energy? Because there is in electromagnetic waves, there is intensity of electric field as well as intensity of magnetic field. That is, electric field is also there, magnetic field is also there. Now what is energy per unit area or unit volume? Or energy per volume, this is also called energy density. Energy density in intensity of electric field E is equal to, can anyone remember? Energy stored in an electric field, that is equal to energy density is your half epsilon naught E square. That is energy density or energy per unit volume in electric field is half epsilon naught E square. In case of magnetic field, energy density or energy per unit volume UB or UH is equal to half mu naught H square. Where H is the magnetic field, E is the electric field. just like this is all these principles, just like half mv square. Half mv square is also energy, we know. Half mv square, half mv square. In case of capacitor, half cv square. So, now what is the total energy density? That is small u is equal to ue plus uv. That is total energy density. That is equal to, that is half epsilon naught e square plus half mu naught h square. That is total energy density. Energy density is nothing but energy per volume. Now the total energy, what is the total energy for volume V? Then total energy U is equal to half epsilon naught e square plus half mu naught h square into d. What is this? The total energy having volume d. The total energy in having volume totally parallel of pipe, what we may consider. But what we require in the definition, the definition of the point we make are integration p dot ds is equal to minus dou u by dou t. According to the definition of the pointing vector. Now, there is dou u by dou t. When the decrease, rate of decreasing energy, that is dou u by dou t is equal to, by taking differentiation, that is minus dou by dou t of u is equal to this one, half epsilon naught e square plus half mu naught h square into d. For whole volume, it may be taken as integration. For whole volume, it is taken as integration. Now, this is equal to minus integration. Dou by dou t of half epsilon naught e square. Half is constant. Epsilon naught is constant. Dou by dou t of e square. 2e into dE by dt. Or maybe dou e by dou t, whatever it is. Am I right? Differentiation of x square is 2x. Just a differentiation of e square is 2e into dou e by dou t. Plus half mu naught are constants. Differentiation of h square with respect to time 2h into dou h by dou t. Into already there is d. Way 2 cancel, 2 cancel. Now minus dou u by dou t is equal to minus integration epsilon naught a into dou e by dou t plus mu naught h into dou h by dou t into d. Now what is the value of dou e by dou t? And what is the value of dou h by dou t? Now we will utilize Maxwell equations in a directive medium. What are Maxwell equations? That is, what is third Maxwell equation? Yeah, third Maxwell equation is del cross E is equal to minus dou v by dou t. But we know b is equal to mu naught h. So that del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou h by dou t. Am I right? Now dou h by dou t is equal to del cross E by minus mu naught. That is one relation. And here dou E by dou t, by taking fourth equation. What is fourth equation? That is del cross B is equal to mu naught into actually J plus dou D by dou T. If in direct media, we know J is equal to 0 in direct media. So that del cross B is equal to mu naught into dou D by dou T. But we know B is equal to mu naught H. And d is equal to epsilon naught e. When substitute these two values into this, del cross mu naught into h
is equal to mu naught into d is your epsilon naught e, that is dou u by dou t, where mu naught cancel. From this, dou e by dou t is equal to del cross h by epsilon naught. Now you want to substitute this dou h by dou t and dou e by dou t into this equation. Then what happens? Minus dou u by dou t is equal to minus integration epsilon naught into e into dou e by dou t is equal to del cross h by epsilon naught and plus mu naught h into dou h by dou t is equal to minus minus into plus minus del, this is not del, del cross e by mu naught into dv is as usual. Now epsilon naught cancel, mu naught cancel. Am I right? Now that is dou u by minus dou u by dou t is equal to minus integration e dot del cross h. If it is minus is taking inside, then what happens? Minus into minus plus, that is h into del cross e minus e into del cross h. Actually this is a vector, h and e are vectors, so it may be taken as dot. So by this is equal to minus dou u by dou t is equal to integration. This by simplification, this can be dot of e cross h into d. A bar dot of b bar cross c bar. We have in vector chapter we used that formula. A bar dot of b bar cross c bar is equal to c dot a bar cross b bar minus b dot a bar cross c bar. Now this is in value integration, but in this first definition is in surface integration. Now you want to change this value integration into surface integration. How can we change? You want to change from value integration to surface integration. How can we change? There is some principle to change from value integration to the surface integration. There is Gauss divergence theorem. Did you remember? According to this Gauss divergence theorem, that is integration f dot dv is del cross dot dv is equal to del dot f dv is equal to integration f dot ds. Gauss divergence theorem already we discussed in previous chapters. Now that is equal to minus dou u by dou t is equal to integration, this is just like f, that is e cross h ds, value integration change into the surface integration. So if this is equation taken as 1, this equation is taken as 2, that is also minus dou u by dou t, here also minus dou u by dou t, and this p dot ds is equal to integration e cross h ds. Now integration p dot ds is equal to integration e cross h ds, both of surface integration, so that p is equal to e cross h. This is the pointing vector which measures the rate of change of energy per unit area in the transport of energy. Okay, thank you.